The intention of tonight's Mass is for, it's called pro populo, which means for the people. So it's for all the parishioners of St. Anthony's and St. Philip's. And every weekend we have one of the Masses for all the parishioners and their families and your loved ones. And tonight, in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
As we come before the Lord this night, we ask his mercy and healing in our lives. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us... Gloria, hang on. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you,
we give you thanks
for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God, almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Keep your family safe, O Lord, with unfailing care, that relying solely on the hope of heavenly grace, they may be defended always by your protection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
A reading from the book of Job. Job spoke, saying, is not man's life on earth a drudgery? Are not his days those of hirelings? He is a slave who longs for the shade, a hireling who waits for his wages. So I have been assigned months of misery, and troubled nights have been allotted to me. If in bed I say, when shall I arise? When the night drags on, I am filled with restlessness until the dawn. My days are swifter than a weaver's shuttle. They come to an end without hope. Remember that my life is like the wind. I shall not see happiness again. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Praise the Lord who heals the brokenhearted.
Praise the Lord who heals the brokenhearted.
Praise the Lord, for he is good. Sing praise to our God, for he is gracious. It is fitting to praise him. The Lord rebuilds Jerusalem and disperses the of Israelite he gathers.
Praise the Lord who heals the
brokenhearted. He heals the brokenhearted and binds up their wounds. He tells the number of the stars. He calls each by name. Great is our Lord and mighty in power. To his wisdom there is no limit. The Lord sustains the lowly, the wicked he casts to the ground.
Praise the Lord and heals the brokenhearted.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, if I preach the gospel, this is no reason for me to boast, for an obligation has been imposed on me, and woe to me if I do not preach it. So if I do so willingly, I have recompense, but if unwillingly, then I have been entrusted with a stewardship. What then is my recompense? That when I preach, I offer the gospel free of charge, so as not to make full use of my right in the gospel? Although I am free in regard to all, I have made myself a slave to all, so as to win over as many as possible. To the weak, I become weak to win over the weak. I have become all things to all to save at least some. All this I do for the sake of the gospel, so that I too may have a share in it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Alleluia, alleluia.
Christ took away our infirmities and bore our diseases.
Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord.
On leaving the synagogue, Jesus entered the house of Simon and Andrew with James and John. Simon's mother-in-law lay sick with a fever. He immediately told him about her. He approached, grasped her hand, and helped her up. Then the fever left her, and she waited on them. When it was evening after sunset, they brought to him all who were ill and possessed by demons. The whole town was gathered at the door. He cured many who were sick with various diseases, and he drove out many demons, not permitting them to speak because they knew him. Rising very early before dawn, he left and went off to a deserted place where he prayed. Simon and those who were with him pursued him, and on finding him, said, "Everyone is looking for you." He told them, "Let us go on to the nearby villages, that I may preach there also. For this purpose have I come." So he went into their synagogues, preaching and driving out demons throughout the whole of Galilee. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Still want to brag it, a little one of my nephews, I think I mentioned before, he's on the poster out there, religious sisters and brothers from the Diocese of Fargo, and his name is Matthew. And today he was a postulant with the bishop, with the Dominicans, the Order of Preachers, and then he went into novitiate and he made temporary vows, and today his group made their final vows, the permanent vows, so now he's officially Dominican Order of Preachers, and he's right now in his studies toward the priesthood. And so I'm very happy for him today, and I congratulate him. And his parents are there with him, so he was very happy about that. And the only thing that bugs me about it is Dominicans are always, they're very smart, first of all. And they don't have any debts, most of them, because they were on scholarships to all their studies. And they look so healthy all the time. So I don't know what it is about Dominicans, but I'm very envious of what he's there. I'm very happy for him. It's sort of like his marriage was today. This reading today in the Gospel follows after the reading from last Sunday. He was in the temple in Capernaum. And he drove out the demon, and it was their Sunday service he was at, the Sabbath, which goes from Friday sunset to Saturday sunset. And so he demonstrated, obviously, by his actions, that he was a regular church goer. So that's to encourage us that the body of Christ comes together. And then it says that he went home to Simon's home, which is not far away. And that's where he stayed, basically. That was Jesus' home, too. For a lot of his ministry, he lived with Simon Peter and his family. And so Simon's mother-in-law was sick. And it says that Jesus approached Simon's mother-in-law, who was later St. Peter, and grasped her hand and helped her up. One of the words that, in the Greek that Mark uses, he raised her up in the verse of the resurrection. And that's what Mark is symbolizing in a lot of these healings. It's the resurrection of life that is a gift given, coming to all of us through Christ. So last week he taught us about coming together, body of Christ, how important that is. And so, like coming to church on Sunday to pray as a body, it's critical. It's we're the spouse of Christ as the body of the church. But also today he demonstrates the importance of personal prayer, intimate prayer of intimacy on our own. It's say when you pray, go to your room, shut the door, and pray to your Father in secret, and your Father in secret will repay you. So it says, Jesus, which you often find in the Gospels, it says many places in the Gospels, he early the next morning, he rose and went off to pray. And that's where Jesus spent his time, just with his Father. You know, what did they talk about? That must have been a pretty powerful prayer. But to commune with God, and him being the second person of the Trinity, I'm sure it was on a different level than us. But it says, communion with God very early, before dawn, even off to a deserted place where he prayed. And that's sort of where he received his strength from. And for us, we have it a little better. We receive the strength from the sacraments, especially the Eucharist, reconciliation. But we're also called when we go forth from here to bring that gospel alive into our communities and our homes, and to throughout the week to remain in that intimacy with the person of Jesus, that personal prayer. So I'm not saying you have to get up very early before dawn. Whenever it works, it has to work according to our state in life. So I have an advantage over all of you. I have a chapel right in my house with the Blessed Sacrament. So, and I better show up. Get that kind of perks. But at home, you know, just as, like St. John Vianney says for prayer, at night when you go to bed, read the scriptures until you find a verse that strikes you to the heart and memorize it. Or you can do it in the morning too, but just one verse. And maybe write it down. And he said, then, as you go throughout your day, when you're tempted to different things, that verse will come to mind. And he said, and by evening, you'll be stronger. And it really works. I've tried that, and it does. You get something in your mind, especially in the morning, or maybe at night before, a scripture passage, and throughout the day, that will come to mind in different situations. And it strengthens us. I mentioned before, I have it's an app on my phone, and every hour a new scripture verse will come up on my phone. And I'll hear it, it's been so long now, every time it beeps, I wonder what's that about, and I go, oh yeah, the scripture verse. So in different ways, but the important thing is that we not only come to be fed as the children of God in the Eucharist, but that once we receive that Eucharist, that we carry out into the workplace, into our families and homes, and then throughout the week, at some point in our day, we need to take time to pray. I know according to our state in life, some have more time, some have less, and it's appropriate. Just do what you can. And if you should tell the high school kids at Shanley, if you stop in the chapel here, in school, 1 minute a day, that means that, let's see, 24, give me a second. That you have over, I think, 6 hours and 5 minutes or something of prayer time in 1 year if you stop and pause for 1 minute a day. At the end of the year, you have been in intimate prayer with Jesus for 6 hours and 5 minutes. That's pretty good. Give it a try.
And now let us profess our faith together. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Now we turn to the Father of the life of the world to come, ask him to hear our prayers and petitions. So we pray for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, our Bishop John, and for all who hold and teach the faith throughout the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all government leaders, for our president, our vice president, our senators, our representatives, our judicial branch, our state legislators, governors, mayors, and community leaders, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our families, our relatives and friends, for those who have asked us to pray for them, those for whom we have promised to pray, for those who have no one to pray for them, for those in need of healing, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all who have passed from this life, that they may be rejoicing in the kingdom of heaven, the glory of God, we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread. We offer you fruit of the earth, the work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Let us eat
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the wine. We offer you fruit of the vine and work of human hands, become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God of prayer.
Please stand. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
O Lord, our God, who once established these created things to sustain us in our frailty, grant, we pray, that they may become for us now the sacrament of eternal life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. So with all the angels, we praise you as in joyful celebration we acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, John, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, and by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who will live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy
that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Please join us for the communion antiphon on page 97. Let them thank the Lord for his mercy, his wonders for the children of men, for he satisfies the thirsty soul, and the hungry he fills with good things.
Now we have the prayer of spiritual communion for those who are joining to us online. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in this most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be parted, separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. O God, who have willed that we be partakers in the one bread and the one chalice, grant us, we pray, so to live, that made one in Christ, we may joyfully bear fruit for the salvation of the world, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
So, you know, the bishop sent out another update this week, and he said that parishes are free to, if they'd like, to resume congregational singing. So, come up with ideas, let me know. I'm open to that. But he just sent that out this week. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
St. Michael, the Archangel,
defend us in battle. Be our defense against the wickedness of sin and the devil.